I think the thing I'm proudest of is the fact that people of all ages seem to love Spider-Man. People come over to me and they're so warm and friendly, and all they want to do is talk about Spider-Man. If you've spent your life working on something and you find out that the fans love what you have done and can't wait to tell you how pleased they are and to thank you for what you've written and done for them, it's an experience I can't even describe how wonderful that feels and how grateful that makes me feel.
Stan Lee and Steve Ditko, goes without saying, they're legends within the comic book industry. They go past legend and into mythology.
To this day, it's the thing that people have to, literally have to imitate.
Both sensibilities really combine to form something unique.
The two pieces of Spider-Man, Ditko and Stan, everything Ditko drew was iconic. Everything Stan wrote was iconic and kind.
And I think the two of them combining their powers created one of the greatest characters probably of all time anywhere.
When it all started, people looked at comics as Bazooka Joe. They didn't get the fact that his brilliance was about the metaphors. Every power that you see is to help us understand ourselves and others.
What you're seeing in the birth of the real age of Marvel Comics is not only Stan's voice, which was clearly a voice you could identify as different than other writers, you have artists coming in who had developed or were developing a voice that was clearly signature and different from what would be the standard.
When I came up with the idea, and when I saw the way Steve Ditko drew it, I was very pleased. It was just what I had in mind.
The reason that Spider-Man matters to kids all over the world is that he's not a rich guy, he's not a god, you know, he doesn't have those kinds of powers. He just grew up in Queens, lives with his aunt, has a normal life, and has all your problems.
I mean, it was radical when the thing that's out there in the world is a more standard superhero. This is a guy who's picked at random. You can tell that it was made by immigrants. It's just got an everyman quality. It's inclusive, and you can tell it in the drawings.
Steve Ditko is an amazing artist. I've admired his comic books from when I was a kid, his knowledge of anatomy, and just the beauty with which he put down the line. I mean, as an artist, if I could possibly be able to bring even like a tiny bit of that into my storyboards, I would just be like, on air.
Ditko had a very powerful, active drawing style. It's like a word in art, Ditko style.
Steve Ditko was so different from what had come before him because his characters had this pathos and anxiety that other superheroes hadn't had before that.
It's kind of a shock because they're really raw, but it's got a sort of bouncy, chaotic kind of energy to it.
Ditko stuff is so clear to me. That's what I find so inspiring about it.
It's always very graphic and the silhouettes are really strong and it's very simple, clean storytelling. And so that was a real inspiration for this movie as far as anytime you have a complicated action sequence with a lot of characters, you want to make sure that the audience can follow what the goal is, what we're supposed to care about, what the emotion is. And so we would sort of think, well, what would Steve do?
He experimented with the way Spider-Man looked, the way the world around him looked. That's something that we were inspired by, you know, not just visual homages to him, but actually trying to take the spirit of all that and embed it in the movie itself.
Steve Ditko really sort of was the leader in a visual revolution, a comic book revolution that started with Marvel and this character, Spider-Man. There isn't one single artist who ever looked at a comic book or, you know, a lover of animation that hasn't been inspired by Steve Ditko. He and Stan Lee really created this entire world that we got to make.
Growing up reading comic books, so many of the incredible comics that were created that have stood the test of time to this day were created by Stan Lee. He had an imagination and he poured himself into his characters.
Stan Lee was actually a very revolutionary like storyteller at the time, because Stan actually, you know, helped put the forefront to actual like a creative narrative throughout like the series of a title.
And his writing is so cheeky and colorful. It was engaging. It was like a lot of exclamation points, mm-hmm. writing directly to the camera. And when you're 12, like you've never seen anything like that before, and it blows your mind. We were all sad to hear Stan's passing. We've been reflecting on what he meant to all of us. And personally, I just remember reading his letters to fans in the comics. Mm-hmm. He would write a little note and it would appear every month. And I remember how inclusive it felt. I remember that he would call us all true believers. It's not a top-down Mount Olympus sort of statement. It is a, we're in this together, we're all in the same club. And here is Stan, who's saying Excelsior, and telling us that even though we were little dorks who pored over these drawings, that there was nothing to be ashamed of, that it was cool and exciting.
Stan was always so inspiring to underdogs. The message that I always got from him was like, you feel different, you can still do great things.
I think that more than anything speaks to the legacy of what he wrote.
Stan Lee always had his eye on the ball in terms of your average person on the street, how are they going to relate to it? And I think Ditko was not afraid to be abstract and was really trying to push a lot of boundaries. And I think with both sensibilities really combined to form something unique.
They found such a simple, elegant truth in that character that anyone from any walk of life can identify with it. If someone says, you are now Spider-Man, and all you have to do is live by, with great power comes great responsibility, what would you do? I wrote Spider-Man for 18 years, and I never got bored. It was constantly feeding me truth to tell. And thinking about that often propelled the story for me. And I, every day, would thank Stan for that.
When I close my eyes, I can see it. The two of them are sitting in this beautiful place with white sky, watching this very old TV and looking at this movie and saying to each other, we love him. Yeah, Miles is cool. Welcome, the new generation.
I'm going to miss him.
Yeah,
we were friends, you know.
Can I return it if it doesn't fit?
It always fits. Eventually.
Excelsior!
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 Excelsior!